Hi guys, in this video I'm going to show you how to numb up a lower first molar using just a buccal articaine infiltration and avoiding an inferior alveolar nerve block. My name is Jazz Galati from the Protrusive Dental Podcast, and this episode, or this video, this bonus little video, is one of the Protrusive Dental Pearls from the Protrusive Dental Podcast, episode 99. If you haven't seen it already, check it out. And this is one of those little nuggets that I give. And one of the questions I've had before over the last few years is, Jazz, I've struggled to give sufficient anesthesia when I'm using the buccal infiltration technique. So a lot of dentists now know that you can use articaine, which is very, very potent, to numb up lower first molars and therefore avoid giving an inferior alveolar nerve block. But a few of my colleagues who've tried it didn't get quite the success, and then now they've fallen back onto inferior alveolar nerve blocks. So in this video, I'm going to show you the actual clinical video of how to do it properly. And I'm going to talk to you step by step, and I'll do some commentary. It's very simple. The crux of it is that you need to first do your usual protocol, give a normal buccal infiltration in the lower molar area. You guys all know how to do that. There's nothing crazy about that. And as you watch this video, I'm gonna jump back in. I'm gonna show you the most important bits in getting success from this technique. So let's catch the clinical video.
Taking the lower left first molar today for these teeth, I like to avoid blocks if possible. Now, is that too bright, Erin? Is that okay?
No, that's good.
Okay, fine. So I like to avoid blocks because blocks have always a slightly more risk. Sometimes we need to. It's a much easier injection technique as well for most dentists. So we're going to be doing an infiltration with articaine. So step number one, some numbing gel. Can you turn your head towards me for me?
Brilliant.
So we're going to leave that there. Wonderful. So it's going to leave that there. Very passionate about things being comfortable as possible. So we'll just leave that there. I'm going to leave it there for about 90 seconds, okay, while I'm preparing my bits and bobs. I could be checking the occlusion, very, very important. To see that, make sure that you conform at the end. Bite together all the way. Tap, 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 tap. Great, and open up. Brilliant. And I'm gonna check the other side as well. Just bring your teeth together. Stay like that. So there we are. I know I'm holding here. So at the end, I should be holding there as well. Okay, open again. Have you got shim stock foil, please? Yep, please, let's have that. So I'd like to check the shim holes and the tooth in front and behind the one I'm treating. So again, while the numbing gel is working, we could be checking all this. Lovely. So 8 microns thick is a shim stock foil. We're going to check it on the 5. Bite together all the way. Stay like that. There we are. We're definitely holding there. And open. And bite together. And we're holding on the 7 as well. So obviously this Miller's is not a great one. And open. Okay, so we're holding on the 7. We're holding on the 5. At the end, I must be holding on the 6 as well. Gives me an idea. We can study the anatomy of the tooth as well. It's fairly flat, so I know that I can't go too crazy with making it look like a 12-year-old's tooth. Got to make it, you know, match the opposing tooth. And always have a look at the opposing tooth as well. So we've got a crown over here. Okay. By now, the numbing gel has had some sufficient amount of time to work. So out comes the cotton. Chair in the right position. So I'll be using some articaine hydrochloride. Now, there is a little sign, okay? That is the way, in the direction in which the bevel is pointing. So I like to point that towards the mucosa. Okay, and I say to the patient, okay, be some tugging and some pulling of your cheek, okay? So what we're doing here now is we're going to the sulcus area. I'm going very slowly, and I'm just literally entering just the mucosa entry point. As I'm doing that, I'm vigorously massaging the cheek, and I'm just, you tell the patient, okay, I'll be just tugging your cheek now, that's what you'll be feeling. At no point have I mentioned the N-word or anything like that, or the P-word. The C-word is comfort, we like to use that word. Okay, brilliant. Yeah. And sometimes what I'll do is, just for the most comfortable technique, just a drop. We've got a drop inside, okay? And already that'd be working now. Did you feel that entry point there?
Yeah.
Okay, there we are. So that's a great sign already. Once you get the few drops in and we don't feel a thing, it's we're winning already. Okay? So now when I go in, I can give it much faster, okay? But we still want to do the good technique of massaging the area. Okay. So perfect. So there we are. You got a good view of that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good. So nice and slowly. I'm just going to go a little bit more now. You're doing really well. Sorry for the taste.
Okay, so this is the most important bit right here. To get sufficient anesthesia, it's all about the attached gingiva. You want to see the attached gingiva blanch. Blanch means it goes white, okay? And then you want to put some mesial and distal, and if you have some left over, put some buccal as well. If you don't have sufficient attached gingiva around the tooth, then this technique is something that I wouldn't use. I would give an inferior alveolar nerve block instead. But if I've got sufficient or normal amounts of attached gingiva, I get good success rates with this technique. So that is really the secret right there. So you can watch that now as well.
If I get best angle to really get into that. There we are. So again, we see the blanching. Okay, can you see that okay, Erin?
Mm-hmm.
Love it. And now, distal. We're around about mid-distal. There we are. Just there. I'm going to deposit the rest inside there so you can see all the blanching all the way along. Okay, and with any anesthetic I have left over, I'm just going to go sub-periosteal, just there. You see that little sulcus area bubble up. And that's it, okay? Some saliva ejection, please, to help with the taste.
Okay, what did you feel much in terms of pain as I was drilling?
No, it's fine.
But you did say at some point you're feeling something. What was that?
I don't know when it was, just when you was like a little bit of pressure. It was just very slight, but it wasn't very much at all.
Overall, a good painless experience, yeah?
Happy with it.
There we are, buccal infiltrations with articaine. There we are, guys. I hope you enjoyed that little tip of how to give sufficient anesthesia using articaine for the lower first molars. If you want more, hit that subscribe button, and I'll catch you in the next one. Thank you.